Next speaker is Her Excellency, Ms. Anna Evstigneeva, Deputy Permanent Representative of the Russian Federation.
Thank you very much, dear colleagues. In the beginning, I would like to thank UN Secretary General, Mr. Gutierrez, and Minister of Foreign Affairs of Norway, Ms. Eriksen Søreide, for organizing today's meeting, as well as for their remarks. We welcome the participation of Prime Minister of Sudan, Mr. Hamdok, and other esteemed participants. Internal political situation in Sudan remains complicated. It is still affected by the developments in Libya, the growing number of IDPs and refugees from neighboring African countries, as well as the spread of coronavirus. Sudan is experiencing profound socioeconomic difficulties, exacerbated by growing inflation and decline in national currency. We note the efforts that the Sudanese authorities are making to improve the situation, including by implementing tough and hard decisions. We therefore stress the need for international political and economic support to Sudanese authorities in order to overcome these challenges. We support activities of the UN Integrated Transition Assistance Mission in Sudan, aimed at sustaining Khartoum's capacity in such core areas as peace building, socio-economic transformation, maintaining domestic peace and legal order. In these circumstances, we attach great importance to maintaining well-balanced contacts with all Sudanese authorities, supporting their efforts to implement the constitutional declaration. We note the commitment of Sudanese leadership to further normalize the situation in Darfur. We strongly call upon all armed groups that so far have remained outside the Juba Agreement to join the peace process. We note steps taken by Khartoum to implement the provisions of this agreement, including through establishment of relevant military committees. We welcome Khartoum's readiness to thoroughly address the root causes of conflict and intercommunal disputes in various regions of Sudan. Prompt implementation of the National Plan for Civilian Protection will be a solid asset in this regard. We are encouraged that the situation in Darfur is gradually getting back to peaceful track. Sporadic intercommunal clashes in some states do not change the overall dynamic. Well-coordinated response of the authorities to the incidents proves Khartoum's commitment to take a comprehensive approach to promoting stabilization. I would like to reaffirm our readiness to support Sudan, both bilaterally and together with our colleagues in the Security Council. Thank you.
Comments.